everybody, this is Joni. I am coming to you with a get ready with me. Somebody had commented and asked that I do a video on my makeup look with one of the Makeup Revolution London palettes. So here it is, and this is the palette that I used. I'll be back in a minute to show you how I did this look. Okay, let's get started. I already washed my face, CeraVe, and it's CeraVe eye repair cream. I put that under my eyes all the time. Now I look for it. I'm just moisturizing. I had already put this toner on, Elizabeth Arden, normal to dry skin. What I'm putting on my face is called Glow by Dr. Brandt Ruby Crystal Retinol Hydra Cream, and that's what I moisturize with. And this makeup, this is new for me. So let's see, it's Revlon Colorstay, and I got it in buff. It has an SPF of 20, and it's for normal to dry skin. They have, it's by Real Techniques, and I do it with this end. And I just kind of go around and blend it in. I don't know if it's really full coverage. I feel like it's not. But let's see after I have all of my makeup on. Under eye is Revolution Conceal and Define. And I just go like that. And I bring it all the way over sort of as a highlighter. I go like a shade lighter than what I usually am. That's just what I'm used to and what I prefer. It's personal preference. I mean, you probably could get a more exact color, but I prefer it a little bit lighter. My eye makeup. Alright, so I have that done. So I'm going to do things the way I normally do them. So you guys wanted to see the Revolution makeup, so I'm going to use the Revolution palette, and this one is called Iconic Lights and Contour Pro Palette. So I use a brush that's nice and fluffy. There it is. I use this brush, and this one is made by Aesthetica, and it says P12. I don't really know brushes, guys, so I'm just dipping it in here, a patting motion. And you want to tap it on the side of your palette, just so that extra fall off comes off before you get one clump of color in your face that you can't blend out. So now this is the darkest shade. I like a little darker contour. Some people make that fish face so they know where to go in. Kind of know where to go in, so you know, like, I don't really need it. You see how nice that comes out? I really like their highlighters. Okay, so that was in their deepest shade, and that was this one. I am going to put that highlighter now. This, if you go rubbing your brush in really heavy, it's going to go on heavy. So really just, you know, lightly. I don't like a contour that's like super heavy. Now, I like to put a little on my nose. Okay, so that was the highlighter. Next, what I do is I go ahead and put my setting spray, my powder on, and then I'm done with my face and I can move on to my eyes. So I take a dry beauty blender, and I use this, it's called Makeup Forever HD. I just take this dry beauty blender, dip it in, and just pat. I'm not baking it. I don't find I need to bake. I just like to set it. Okay, so that's that. So, and then the, oh, you know what? I forgot. I don't have any, I don't have any blush that's made by them. I'm sorry. So I'm going to use this sample size of Too Faced. I got it years ago. And look at it. I have so much left still. It was a sample that came with something. And I love this. It's just so pigmented. And it's just a nice shade for me. Now I'm going to go ahead and powder my face and set it. And then I am good to go for my face. And I like this translucent powder. I also like It Cosmetics. They put out a good brand, but they're kind of pricey. I'm going to go with this one. This is Revolution Makeup London. And now, you know what? Yeah, this is one of their palettes that has a lot of colors in it. I'm going to go with that because some of my favorite colors are in there. And what I use to for my primer on my eyes is Revlon Photo Ready. And it looks like this. And you just twist off the cap. You twist this up and the liquid advances into the brush. So I put that on and I kind of just, you know, just get it all over my brow. Then I do it again and go to this side. I'm going to do my eyelid with this color. That's kind of like, I like to put a base coat. Now, you know what? I'm going to do it with this color here. I like to do my whole eye with one color. This way, I have like a clean palette. So, you know, because I'm still even a little ruddy up here. So this way, everything's even. Now I've just set my primer and I've got my whole eye in the same color. Okay. I am going to go with this color right here. And I can't tell you the name of it because it just doesn't have the name of it on it. But I'm going to go in the crease. And I kind of go heavy on my eyes closer to the outside corner. I'm no expert on makeup. By profession, I'm a nurse, but I love makeup. I always feel better when I have my makeup on. Now, you see how my eyes are doing that? That's because of my age. You know, my skin is a little crepey here. So if I just go like this, when I was younger, I would do the windshield wiper thing. I can't do that anymore because look what happens. My skin moves with me. So I have to do a little bit, sometimes a little more padding in or dragging, you know, either up or down than some of you younger folks. So, you know, you all know what, especially over here, but you girls all know what works better for you. And then I come down here in the corner and do that. And, you know, I just do a real simple look. I do like two eyeshadows, maybe three. For the most part, you know, I stay on the lighter side. Oh, that brush that I used, I don't know what that is. I get a lot of my brushes from BoxyCharm. The Vintage Cosmetic Company. And it just says step one for the money. It doesn't say, you know, like what color or anything. So this is the brush I'm going to use for my eyelid. And this is an e.l.f. brush. And it says, well, this says the eye crease brush. I'm using it for my lid. And I want to go for, I am going to go for this color here. It's just a nice, almost taupey color. And then I think I'll go over it with something with a little bit of a sparkle. And if you guys don't have one of these guys, you really should get one. One of these spongy things that you can clean out your brush with. This way you're not using 100 brushes. It really does a good job. I mean, look at this. Nothing. Okay, so I want to go over it with something glittery. So I am going to use this shade right here. That sparkly one. And I'm just doing that on the outer corner. And into the crease, just a little. I tend to keep like the inside, this part of my eye, a little bit lighter than the outside. And I still have to put a little highlighter in the inside corner of my eye. I like that too. You know what? I think I might try. I haven't used this color yet. See that? It's got like gold flecks in it. I think I might use that on the inside of my eye. Let's see what happens. I don't know. It almost looks like a very light gold. It's definitely got some glitter in it. I think, let's see if I use that for my highlight in here. Just in here, I like to put a little dusting of something to draw. Oh yeah, that's nice there. Just to draw the eye in there. Oh, very nice. I am going to use, this is a brown pencil, and it is made by Janta Blue. And I got this in my last BoxyCharm. So brown gives you a nice daytime look. I like black at night. I find the brown just isn't dark enough for at night. I mean, you can see it. I go just below my waterline. I have allergies. And so if I put it on my waterline, my eyes are always tearing and it doesn't stay for me. So this is how I do it. Happy with the way it came out. I like that palette. It's one of my favorites of their palettes, but I'll be honest with you, I do a lot of mixing. I'm gonna try and do my eyebrows, but I'm warning you guys, I am eyebrow challenged, just like probably everyone else. It is the thing I hate doing the most, and I'm the worst at. It is just so hard to get them even. Somebody said to me, they don't have to be twins. They have to be cousins. I'm not perfect. Why am I not surprised? That's a little better. This that I'm using, there's two kinds of eye pencils that I use. And this one is the It Cosmetic one. It's a universal brow. The other one that I use is the Anastasia Beverly Hills. I use the NYX Dewy Finish to set my makeup. Yep, this is Gold Bell. And this is the color. It's like a mauve, neutrally color. So I'm going to just put some lip liner on. Oh, Lorac is who makes that. This is Rimmel Exaggerate is the brand. And there you have it. There is my look with my Makeup Revolution London in the, it's called Fortune Favors. That is the palette. And it looks like this. But any of their palettes are good. So go ahead and buy a palette and give it a shot and see if you like it. It's real money saving. All right, guys. Bye for now.